Hi everyone, welcome back. So certification and interview questions from MuleFlow or MuleFlow Scope. So we already discussed few questions in part one and this is part two. So let us jump on to the first question in part two. So what is reusable object containing parameters that have any number of elements in a flow can share? So answer for this is global element. And global element related question can be asked in many ways. We can expect this question in, we can expect one question in exception handler. Where do we configure global exception handler? So that means we configure it at global elements, right? And where do we configure HTTP property details? And also, you know, we use global elements to for the reusability. So when we are configuring, you know, database related details or HTTP host port details, so we no need to, you know, when we want to reuse that, you know, if we configure that in global element, we can reuse it anywhere in a flow. So we can expect global element related question in many ways. So let us jump on to the second question. Review the given flow diagram. Let us see the flow diagram here. So here we have a listener setting a payload and first logger and flow reference. With this flow reference, we are connecting to this and then second logger. So the question is, what is the payload value at the second logger? So what is the payload value at the second logger? And you know, we can, they'll also give XML in a certification exam. It is very small, right? Let me show you in a studio. So this is related, this flow, this XML is related to that. So here what we need to observe is flow reference is there, right? So in the flow reference, we are using, I mean, it is using target equal result and target value is payload, means it is saving the response data into a variable. Okay, it is saving the response data into a variable. So this response data, it is saving into a variable. So what is the value, sorry, what is the payload value at second logger? So at the first logger, what is the payload value? What it is setting? See, name Mike. And the child flow, what it is setting? Email Mike at Gmail. So here it is setting name. So here we are setting payload name and here we are setting email. So what you can expect here? So as it is saving a payload from child flow in a variable, so the actual payload here we can expect the same from the starting, means name. So what is the answer for this? A is the answer. But if let us see this. So let me execute this and then we can do one modification to this and we can see the difference. It is deploying. Almost done. Yeah, it is deployed. So what is the listener that we have configured here is order. Okay. Yep, order. Just sending the request to that. And we can see here what it is printing. So what is printing? At the first logger, payload is name equal to Mike. And at the second logger, payload is same, name equal to Mike. So let us do one modification here. So here we are saving the payload into a variable, right? This time removing this and then we can see the difference now. I just saved it and it is redeploying the project. Yep, it is deployed. Let me send the same request now. See what it is printed. So first logger place, we can see name equal Mike, and then the second logger, email equal mike@gmail.com. So this we need to observe in XML target. So we can see this target for HTTP connector also in HTTP questions. We looked into this. So thank you guys. We can meet in the next video. For more updates from integrations, please subscribe to this channel and good luck.